Jay Shaw is a PhD student at Arizona State University, researching on building interpretable AI models for healthcare disorders like Alzheimer's disease and post-traumatic headache. In the past, he has interned at NTU Singapore HackerRank, Philips Research Labs, and also worked with a Nobel laureate. Jay also hosts a podcast about machine learning for beginners, which now has more than 50,000 downloads and 1,650 plus subscribers. He was recently named an IEEE Impact Creator. Thank you so much for joining us, Jay. And that's interesting that you say that podcast helped give you exposure to the subject, considering you've now created this YouTube channel. What's been your biggest challenge of creating a YouTube channel that focuses specifically on machine learning?
Yeah, in terms of challenges, I think, of course, you are also a podcast host and you also might have came across these challenges is asking the right sort of questions to the person. So I think when I'm researching these people who I want to be a guest on my podcast, it definitely these people have immense amount of research expertise. So asking them, first of all, maybe if I ask them a question like, what does machine learning mean to you? It would have some kind of different flavor to it. So asking the right set of questions to these people is definitely a big challenge for me, but something I really enjoy, because trying to learn what machine learning means to them, every time I get a different response, and maybe understanding their motivation. So I think figuring out who is the best speaker and who can really help young engineers, because the idea of that podcast channel is to help young machine learning enthusiasts get into the world of machine learning, right? So trying to bridge those pros and cons of both the worlds, I'm also trying to help students versus I'm also trying to make sure that the podcast host or the podcast speaker has a great time being on the podcast. So I think those kind of balancing things really feel challenging, but I really enjoy it. It's a great deal of thing that is typically not taught in textbooks anywhere. So it's definitely fun, yeah.
And that's what I've noticed. Your interview is so conversational. It's so relaxed. It's very interesting, but it almost feels like I'm a fly in the wall sitting in your living room, just taking in the discussion. I wonder if that's what's led to, I think there's over 1,500 plus subscribers on this YouTube channel. And with it being such a niche topic, I'm curious what you think has led to this level of interest.
Yes, I think the unique selling point of the podcast would be, I try to make it for example, even before I created these podcasts, I used to listen to a lot of podcasts, and they were often into the two amazing buckets. You would feel extremely technical, where the person would go on talking about the research, and the person who's listening, who might not have understanding, might just feel bummed out. I don't know into much that much depth of machine learning. And versus somebody would be talking too much superficial, that, hey, machine learning is cool, it's going to change the world. The movies like Terminator are going to be real and people are going to die and killed by AI. And these two extremes were definitely fun, but they are not the reality. So people who are starting into the machine learning are somewhere in between. They also want to be technical, but they also want to have some fun. I'm sure most of the machine learning researchers have some kind of very amazing own personal life agenda, how they got into machine learning, right? So I think the unique point I try to cover through these podcasts is maybe understand their stance of what does machine learning research mean to them, and then maybe ask some very, very short and very sweet technical questions. What do you mean by these kind of technologies? What do you see yourself, what do you see these fields going into the next few years? And I think that kind of getting a sweet spot, maintaining between the speaker's interest and also the listener's interest, has maybe led to a good amount of people who are interested into listening to these podcasts. Yeah.